However, I'm sure it will not take from the excitement that we all expect, and indeed the huge following down in the stand here for this vocational school final between St. Aidan's Cootehill and Ballybay Community College. Quite a good turnout, quite a good crowd, and no doubt in the course of the afternoon that there will be lots of excitement and lots of cheering and all that fair bit of flair when, of course, colleges meet or schools in any competition, in any match, and I'm sure this afternoon it will be something similar, no doubt. Now, very, very shortly, the game will be getting underway, and referee out in the centre. The pitch a little bit greasy up here to the right, but still looking quite good as always, and one would, I suppose, have to say it's an unusual time of the year, really, that we should be here on a Tuesday, well, to cover a match. But we're going to have perhaps as much, if not more, excitement in this one. I'm almost convinced of that at this stage. Now, we're only seconds away from the throw-in. It's St. Aidan's Cootehill against Ballybay Community College. The referee gets the game underway. and stalemate for a moment, but eventually picked up in the middle here for St. Aidan's. Cootehill by Paul McEnroe. A short ball out to the far side of the field, gathered up by Keith Fanning. Keith Fanning right through the centre, but is intercepted down at the other end by the cornerback for Ballybay, Pat Fitzpatrick, and Fitzpatrick with a long clearance from defence right up to attack, up into an open space deep inside the 70-yard line, but it's intercepted back here in the back line for St. Aidan's, and coming away with it, John McCary, 50 yards, make it 70 yards now from his own goal. A long ball right in towards the 21, the 14, but there's a bit of pushing in the back up here to the left, and the referee awarding a free outfield to Ballybay Community College, about 24 or 5 yards out from their own end line, way out towards the far side of the field. Our coverage on the game this afternoon being brought to you in association with Sean Shields Bookmakers, where they have updates and prices on every event, and indeed early morning prices on every event and every race as well. And they are in Cavan, Cootehill, Ballyborough and Virginia. I wonder what the odds are on this final here today. Ball out over the sideline from the resulting free on the far side, and the line ball to St. Aidan Cootehill, not a very good one by any means. Well, it is grabbed by the centre forward here, and now Jonathan Rutledge slipping to the ground, coming in support here is Stephen Fitzpatrick, the centre half back inside the 50-yard line, breaking the ball out to Paul Stewart. Paul Stewart is fouling, the referee is awarding a free in just inside the 50-yard line down here to our right. Ballybay Community College play from left to right in this first half as we look down, and a very slight breeze, if anything, blowing somewhat across in this direction across the field, so obviously it will not be really an advantage to anybody this afternoon, and let's hope that it won't spoil the game, but it's not too strong. Meanwhile, the free inside the 45 metre line, about 42 or 3 metres out from the Cootehill goal mark down here to our right, and about 15 yards to the left of the goal mark on the right, and they've organised a short one where it comes to Paul Finley, back out a high one from way out the field, but it's gone out to the right of the upright and it's wide. First attack really there coming in from Ballybay, but that one winding up out over the end line, so it's just an ordinary kick out down here to our right. Just about 2 minutes gone into the first half, and certainly a very wintry afternoon, and a very, very heavy shower indeed just before the ball was thrown in. Meanwhile, the kick out down here by David Ward, St. Aidan's goalkeeper, flicked down a little bit further by Keith Fanning, way out to the far side again to an open space, pulled on along the ground on the far side by Donald Cassan. In after it for Ballybay on the far side is the cornerback Patrick Fitzpatrick, who seemed to be roving way out the field there, but his clearance a short one out over the sideline on the far side. So this is a line ball to St. Aidan's, just on the halfway line, out to the far side, and Keith Fanning to take the kick, and he will send it along and in towards the 20-metre line. Knocked away from the full-back here by the full-forward momentarily, but there to gather it up back in defence, Niall Traynor for Ballybay, and then the clearance up to the 70-yard line, but in the middle for St. Aidan's, lobbing, dropping ball back in towards the goal mouth again. It's hopping towards the edge of the square, but out comes Emmett Gleeson, the goalkeeper, and his clearance is blocked and smothered by the full-forward, Aidan Lennon. Aidan Lennon gets it back in now towards the 14-yard line, but the goalkeeper is back in, and the shot in towards the goal mouth is blocked by the goalkeeper and eventually tapped out to this side into the open space, and coming away downfield is Niall Donaghy for Ballybay Community College, and he gets it up with the centre now to Noel Coyle. Noel Coyle 60 yards out from his own goal mouth, right up through the centre. Ballybay looking good now in the early moments, and it's the full forward Brian Lennon. Lennon with the ball inside his own 70-yard line, right wing one high and dropping way out towards the right here, going back down after here. Gerard Argy in there too is Niall Donaghy, and Donaghy goes down to get up the ball, but trips, and eventually the ball breaking out loose and eventually cleared out into the centre field area, where it's collected by Paul McEnroe from Drumgoon. St. Aidan's Cootehill up into the centre of the field, but down at the other end and coming away outfield there for Ballybay, Jonathan Rutledge. This is the player that got the baptism of fire really before the game. Meanwhile, referee has blown his whistle, and there's a free just inside the 45 metre line out towards the far side to Ballybay Community College, that is, and to be taken by the right half forward Brian McCabe. Now to the full forward Brendan Lennon. Brendan Lennon's racing through, takes a shot, and a great save by the goalkeeper. Lennon was right through there, a blasting shot, and it looked to be going towards the left corner, and David Ward dived in desperation, got it out, back out to the 40-yard line, where it was collected out there by Michael Hannon, and Michael Hannon turned around and then sent the ball over the bar, the first score of the game there from the Ballybay midfielder, and that coming after about, exactly 5 minutes of play in the first half. But what a save back here by David Ward. David plays his club football with Kill Shamrocks, and he's coming out now to place the ball on the 20-metre line. That's precisely what he does. Damp conditions, no doubt, out there, but at least for the moment it's not raining, though there was that heavy shower. Here comes David Ward now with the kick, and the game hasn't really ignited yet, but no doubt that it will. Dropping a bit short of the 70-yard line. On the far side, Michael Hannon. Michael Hannon right up to the middle now for St. Aidan's Cootehill. Knocking it down here was the full back, but there to pick it up, Brian Bates. And Brian Bates taps it into Shane McGarry. McGarry going through on the 14-yard line. He takes the shot, and he's put it out over the end line and wide. I thought he might have been going for a goal even there, but he was coming in from the far right. Did go for the point, but it went out to the right, and it went wide. So it's after 6 minutes of play, it's 1 point for Ballybay Community College, and St. Aidan's Cootehill, they have yet to score. Just over 6 minutes gone in the first half here, and the ball being placed down here at the goalmouth on the left by Emmett Gleeson. Emmett too plays his club football with Ballybay coming out now with the kick out. Some dropping around the 45-metre line, nobody really there to catch it. Well, plenty of people, but they seem to all fail in catching it. Aidan Lennon was tripped then as he gathered up a breaking ball, and the referee awarding a free in. Looked a simple one, but however, the referee awarding the free in just on the edge of the semicircle down here to our left, and the centre forward is Aidan Crossan, and he's the player that's going to take the kick. At 7 points in the Ulster semi-final, and his effort out over the end line and wide. And certainly if St. Aidan's are to pick up the Markey Cup, they'll want to be going somewhat more direct for the target, really. That's their second wide in within a minute almost. Ballybay with 1 point in a game that's now coming up to 7 minutes of the first half. Meanwhile, Emmett Gleeson once again to place on the edge of the square and kick out for Ballybay down here to our left. They play from left to right in this first half. One of the Ballybay players down here for a moment, just receiving some attention outside the edge of the semicircle. But I have a feeling that he will be back up very, very shortly. The referee just stalling the play here for a moment. The sun trying to come out, and even if it did, that downpour that we had before the game would certainly be leaving conditions very, very greasy indeed. Now then, back to the kick out, and Paul Finlay is down, is back up now, and we await the kick out from Emmett Gleeson down here to our left. And as Emmett comes forward with this kick out, it's right footed and again dropping short to the 45-metre line. But a breaking ball is gathered up here by Noel Coyle. Noel Coyle out to the far side of the field, where Jonathan Rutledge is back in defence. Gets it a little bit further up towards the 70-yard line. Right through the centre now. A strong, bright sun, a glaring sun now. In fact, here in Clonus, and a bit of a drizzle overhead. However, St. Aidan's are defending down here to our right and coming forward now towards the halfway line, and then a delivery out to this side of the field to the left half forward with Kieran McBrain. Kieran on the 70-yard line looking for support. He finds it in Aidan Crossan. Aidan Crossan right through the centre, and the ball transferred out to the left now here to Mark Kelly outside the 21-yard line. He's trying to work it inside to what he perhaps thought was a loose pair, but there's nothing loose out there. Now it's Kieran McBrain, then the central forward, Aidan Crossan, but his pass going completely astray, and the ball eventually grabbed and cleared out to this side of the field, where it's gone, in fact, out over the sideline, and there will be a line ball down here to our left, to St. Aidan's, and it's halfway between the 45 and the 20-metre line down to our left. 1 point for Ballybay. St. Aidan's Cootehill have yet to score. The short line ball, and eventually, well, it was gathered up by Brian Bates, and Brian then fumbled it a little bit, but then got back to it, gathers it up. Now he's been fouled, and the free in. About 30 metres out from the goalmouth, down here to our left. So this one is also about 15 to 18 metres to the left of the goalmouth on the left. 1 point for Ballybay and Cootehill. They have yet to score. Are they about to score? This one is high and sailing towards the clouds, but it's knocked down by the full back. There is the full forward tore in after it. When the ball dropped to the ground, he tried to pull on it, but it was never going to work, and it eventually has been cleared out by the full back, Sean McCabe, for Ballybay, out over the sideline, and the line ball once again down here to our left. 1 point to no score with Ballybay Community College out in front in a game that's now over 9 minutes of the first half. Aidan Crossell, the centre half forward, lobbing one out to the left of the upright, and again he's put it wide. Three wides and no score for St. Aidan's Cootehill, while Ballybay have that 1 point, and we've just 7 minutes, or 9 minutes rather, gone in this first half here of this Ulster Vocational School's football final between these near neighbours. Emma Cleason with the kick out once again down to our left, and the crowd somewhat subdued, yet they are expecting greater things. The kick out being a little bit short, but nevertheless the centre half back for Ballybay after it. Then Edmund Lennon tapping it out to this side. Now it's Stephen with Patrick tapped it across into the centre to the midfielder Noel Coyle right up through the middle. The referee has again blown his whistle, and a quick free to Ballybay right into the semicircle now to Rutledge. Jonathan Rutledge slipping to the ground, pulling on the ball out to the open space. In after it there also was the left half forward Paul McCabe, but it was eventually grabbed back here in defence and about to be cleared by Gerard Argy for St. Aidan's, and Gerard's long clearance right up to the 70-yard line, a little short of it, and there to find it was Aidan Crossell grabbing the ball and tapping it across into Paul McEnroe. Paul McEnroe 70 yards out, now on the halfway line, the little sidestep, then advancing, going forward, and the right footed run into the centre of the semicircle, knocked down by Niall Trainor, out to Pat Fitzpatrick on the far side. In turn it's Stephen Fitzpatrick for Ballybay, and Stephen coming away with the ball out to the 70-yard line once again. This time it's Paul Finlay. Paul Finlay right through the centre of the 45-metre line, and Ballybay on the attack again. This time it's Brendan Lennon, the full forward, and the captain also, and still Brendan Lennon trying to get inside, but conditions are rather slippy up there as he drops the ball to the ground, then pulls on it out to the far side, where it will be picked up here sooner, perhaps, if not later, by the right half forward Brian McCabe. And Brian McCabe for Ballybay back in towards the semicircle again. They're certainly mounting a lot of pressure on this Cootehill defence, and eventually Brian McCabe for 25 yards out attempting a high one, and he's put it over the bar. Now they did make hard work of it, but they also made good work of holding possession, so to speak, and eventually Brian McCabe sending that one over to make it Ballybay Community College on 2 points, and St. Aidan's Cootehill have yet to score. And David Ward placing on the 20-metre line down here to the right once again for the kick-out. St. Aidan's playing from right to left, and that drizzle continues, though the sun is there as well. Certainly not a very pleasant afternoon for outdoor sport. However, David Ward with the kick-out, and our coverage being brought to you this afternoon in association with Sean Fields, bookmakers Cootehill, Baylor of Virginia and Cavan. And Ballybay coming forward now again. It's Paul Finlay landing one back in again, but this time it's been gathered up by John McCary, the right corner back for St. Aidan's. Taps it out to the far side where Keith Fanning was there, and eventually gets it up to the halfway line. And now it's Aidan Crossell, the centre half forward, hovering out around the centre field area, but loses it to Noel Coyle right through the middle to Paul Stewart inside the 70-yard line for Ballybay, punching the ball forward, but then follows it up, gathers it up and gets it inside himself, in towards the 21-yard line, breaking out to the right here to Niall Donaghy chipping it out a little bit further towards to our right down here. And the centre half back is Stephen Fitzpatrick, who's way up in attacking position, landing one way out towards the far left, and in doing so it's gone out over the end line and wide. So it's Ballybay Community College on 2 points, and St. Aidan's Cootehill, they have yet to score. Ballybay, of course, being steered in this competition by former Monaghan and indeed Ulster star, one of the great exponents of the game in Paddy Kerr. Ball being placed on the edge of the square. Paddy, incidentally, who won senior championship medal with UCD in Dublin, and indeed an All-Ireland club medal with same, not to mention a Sigerson Cup. That's just part of his record. Meanwhile, from the kick out to the 50-yard line on the far side of the field, the ball breaking once again. And as it does, Keith Fanning goes down on it for St. Aidan's and taps it across into the centre. Players are finding it most difficult to adapt to these terrible conditions. And Cootehill losing possession now, and coming outfield is Patrick Fitzpatrick from Latton. And Patrick gets it right up through the centre for Ballybay, where the centre back again, Stephen Fitzpatrick, is out here. He too tries to get it up, and indeed finally succeeds in doing so, and gets it out to the left to Paul McCabe on the 21. There's a score or two of this fella. He got 7 points in the semi-final as he swings it right across in front of the goal mouth, but out comes the Out comes the corner back for Cootehill McCary, and here's it down to the centre where Aidan Crossan was fouled, and there's a quick free right up to the middle. Full forward for St. Aidan's coming out to it. Aidan Lennon, 25 yards out, chipping it way out to the far right. A shot here that's going and going, and it's got in for a goal. Got in for a goal, and it was Shane McGarry that got it. Aidan Crossan that started that move, but it was Shane McGarry that got that one. Came in from the far right and sent it in just inside, about a foot inside the post, giving the goalkeeper no chance. But it's that sort of an afternoon that it's certainly very difficult to gauge or indeed control. But he did well. He took the effort and moved in to take the shot and get his goal. So it's 1 point now for St. Aidan's. And Ballybay, they are on 2 points, and that goal coming after 15 minutes and 20 seconds of this first half. Meanwhile, Emmett Gleeson with the kick out for Ballybay once again from the 20 metre line down here to our left. This one dropping between the 45 and the 70 yard line. Crossan coming forward again. Crossan tapping the ball forward, then taking a return pass. Now 25 yards out, gets a bit of a thump just as he got rid of the ball, but the referee gave him the advantage, and he took the shot that went out to the right, and it went wide. One goal for St. Aidan's, and Ballybay, they are on 2 points, and we've 16 minutes now gone into this first half. Meanwhile, Emmett Gleeson once again to kick out down here to our left for Ballybay Community College, bidding for a first at this age, under 18, of course, for a first title in this. Meanwhile, the kick out again, dropping away short of the 50-yard line. And however, it's Ballybay defence that gather the ball up and tear it way out to the side of the field. The clash of the Giants down here in front. And the man that comes up trumps with the ball is Gerard Argy. Gerard Argy for Cootehill. Gerard on the 50-yard line. Nice ball control as he gets it back up to the halfway line again, where St. Aidan's are coming forward in the name of Paul McEnroe. And Paul McEnroe going forward, then taps it to Kieran McBrain. McBrain back out to Crossan. Crossan 35 yards out, right footed, high, lobbing, dropping, dangerous one. And it's over the bar. Just about dropped straight down behind the crossbar. The goalkeeper's fingers also very close to it, but it was so high coming down straight, and it did drop in and over the bar. So it's a goal and a point now for St. Aidan's Cootehill and Ballybay Community College. They are on 2 points. These sides, of course, have already met in this particular competition. In the first game, they finished level, and in the second game, well, St. Aidan's Cootehill had something little to spare. They won it. Meanwhile, from the kick out, from the 20-metre line down towards the 65-metre line, knocked down in the middle. Here is Brian Bates for St. Aidan's Cootehill, dropping it back in again. The pressure is mounting, the ball is hopping, but it hops out over the end line and wide. And certainly a lot of wides where Cootehill are concerned in this first half to date, and first half at 17 minutes gone. But despite that, they do have a goal and a point, and Ballybay, who started off well, they have just those 2 points. Meanwhile, Emmett Gleeson again to kick out from the edge of the square down here to our left. Ballybay play from left to right in this first half as we look down, just to give you a graphic description. Two schools that were formed, indeed came on stream back in the year 1966, down to the 50-yard line. Well controlled back here by Stephen Fitzpatrick. Coming forward, rather the midfielder Noel Coyle. Noel Coyle right-footed, right up through the middle. Not a very long ball. It's intercepted back here at the other end for St. Aidan's by the centre-back, Donan Cassan. And Cassan lobbing it back in towards the 14-yard line once again. And Cootehill about to go forward here, but good defensive work back here. Though there's a foul. The referee awarding a free-in for the foul, all right, on the 14-yard line. Just a little to the left, the foul committed, and the foul, the man that was in possession, incidentally, was Mark Kelly. So the free for St. Aidan's on the 20-metre line down here to our left, and this will be taken by Aidan Lennon. Aidan, incidentally, who is a member of the Latin Club, or one of the Monaghan players, playing with St. Aidan's Cootehill. He has sent the ball in anyway, and he's put it over the bar. So it's now a goal and 2 points for St. Aidan's, and Ballybay with 2 points. Just a goal between them. And we have just over 19 minutes gone in this first half. Meanwhile, Emmett Gleeson once again to kick out. Emmett apparently claims that the ball that he was about to kick out had lost some air, so he's called for a second one, and his request has been granted, so he now places on the 20-metre line to take this kick out. And again, I say, it's difficult to know if that breeze is of any advantage or indeed harm. It's a breeze that appears to be blowing across towards this side. This is a good long kick out down to the 70-yard line, but it's St. Aidan's in the middle again, and Aidan Crossan out to the far side to Shane McGarry. Shane McGarry tapping it out to the far right to Brian Bates. Inside the semicircle now, a right-footed swinging ball in towards the 14-yard line, but it's knocked out a little bit and tapped out into an open space. But pulling away with the ball for Ballybay is the centre-forward Paul Stewart. And Paul Stewart driving it forward, up to the full forward, Brendan Lennon. Brendan Lennon a little bit further in to their number 13 with a shot. And it's put in for a goal. It's a goal for Ballybay, and Niall Donaghy it was that went forward. The number 13, he went forward, took the shot, and it was a good hard shot. The goalkeeper for a second seemed to have it covered, but he failed to hold it that time and drove it in. And it's now one goal and 2 points for St. Aidan's Cootehill. And Ballybay have now also a goal and 2 points. And that was in no way a surprise goal, because Niall did very well as he went out there. He went forward there with great panache and great power, and a very hard shot that David Ward, well, failed to hold it, and so the ball went into the left-hand corner. With the sides level, and that goal coming after exactly 20 minutes of this first half. Perhaps the game needed something, and I wonder if it got it from the kick out to the centre field area once again, but it's brought down in the middle this time for Cootehill, down in the middle. McEnroe with the was fouled incidentally, and he took the quick free himself out to the open space. Kieran McQueen lobbing it in towards the general direction of the goal mouth. In fact, it's about 10 metres out to the right, out over the end line, and it has dropped wide. The Davies incidentally, who are down 7 points in their drawn match against Ballygawley, but made a great recovery in the last 5 or 6 minutes and lived to fight another day. Emmett Leeson placing on the edge of the square down here once more for the kick out for Ballybay Community College. Emma coming forward now with this kick out. I'm not so sure if it's the breeze or not, but certainly a lot of the kick outs are dropping short of that 50-yard line. However, there to pick up a breaking ball was Edmund Lennon for Ballybay, right up to the centre. And now they're coming forward again, this time towards the 50-yard line. But again, players are slipping and sliding. Now it's Paul McCabe. He had 7 points in the semi-final. Paul McCabe into the semi-circle, still in possession, then transfers to the centre forward, the other Paul, and that's Paul Stewart, but Paul's kick has gone out to the left of the post, and it's gone wide. 1 goal and 2 points each after 22 minutes of play in the first half. And our coverage this afternoon being brought to you in association with Sean Shields, bookmakers, Cavan Cootehill, Ballybor and Virginia. Up-to-date prices on every event. Early morning prices also on every event and all the races. And again, I wonder what the odds might be on this afternoon. From the edge of the square down here, David Ward will kick out once more for St. Aidan's Cootehill. As he places the ball very, very careful. Meanwhile, David Ward with this kick out now for Cootehill, coming forward then down to the 50-yard line. The kick out's on both sides, certainly a little bit weak. But then it's a ball that they're playing with. It would be somewhat heavy this afternoon because of all the rain and all the inclement weather. Meanwhile, Ballybay pressing forward again. The referee says there was a foul. He was right, and a free to Ballybay, quickly taken by the centre forward. And now it's Paul Finlay, 35 yards out to the far left, trying to set up another score, but it's going to be intercepted back here by Paul McEnroe for St. Aidan's, and Paul's delivery down to Shane McGarry on the far side. Shane, the right half forward, back helping the defence. His clearance up along the far side, but however, it's gathered up by Enda Keenan. Enda Keenan delivers it up along the far wing, and there to meet it, Patrick Fitzpatrick from Latin, and Patrick dropping it into the 21-yard line. Heard it comes now to Jonathan Rutledge, and Jonathan shot into the goal mouth, in indeed on the goalkeeper's chest, and David Ward grabbed, this time held tight, and cleared it out to this side where it's going close to the sideline, but it's not out over it yet. The referee has penalised St. Aidan's here for some unnecessary holding or pushing down here to our right on the midfielder being Paul Finlay, and the free will be to Ballybay about 30 metres out from the Cootehill goal mouth down here to our right. Very, very close to the sideline also, virtually on the sideline, about 30 metres out. Referee just checking that Paul Finlay is okay after that particular foul. Still checking him out to make sure that he can recover quickly and indeed continue, and I think continue he will. Not only that, he's going to have a go at this one. A ball that he will, I'm sure, no doubt, lob in around the goal mouth or perhaps he's going to try and engineer something. He's having a gawk inside to see if there might be somebody loose. But there ain't too many loose things back here in defence, as he comes forward now with a left-footed one that's high, and it will drop around the edge of the square out to the far side. In fact, it's brought down by John McDonald, a full-back, and John was fouled coming out with the ball, so he takes the free himself down to the 45-metre line. Again, ball breaking hither and thither. Headed up there by Cootehill, who are looking perhaps for a little bit of over-carrying. However, the referee on the play, and as the ball is delivered up along the near side, St. Aidan's full forward had possession all right, Aidan Lennon, but not for very long. He was robbed illegally, and the clearance out over the sideline, and the line ball to St. Aidan's, taken by Keith Fanning down along this near side, where Aidan Lennon, the full forward, has come out to it. And Aidan Lennon on the 20-metre line, tapping it across into the centre. The left half forward here is Kieran McBrain, finding it most difficult now to get in through. The ball was picked up from very, very close to the ground. However, the referee says work away, and it's the Ballybay defence that are about to clear back here in the name of Niall Traynor out towards the 21-yard line. But it's Aidan Crossan that meets it, and Aidan Crossan moving across into the centre then takes a shot from about 21 yards out, but he's put it wide, so the score remains a goal of 2 points each. 1-2 for Ballybay, 1-2 for St. Aidan's Cootehill. This Ulster Vocational School's football final here at St. Tiernach's Park in Clonus. Meanwhile, Emmett Leeson to kick out once again. And again, I say, the audience are somewhat subdued. Maybe that's something to do with the nature of the game, because the game hasn't really got off the ground, so to speak. And I suppose we can blame the weather for that. However, Emmett Leeson with the kick out once again for Ballybay down here to our left. 5 points each. 26 minutes gone in this first half. The Ballyvay Community College, of course, bidding and hoping for their first success at this level in Cavan. This particular competition was won before, back in 1975, by Virginia Vocational School, and indeed in 93 by Cavan Vocational School. Meanwhile, Ballyvay defending once again up through the centre, up to the 70-yard line. Down at the other end here is Gerard Argy. Gerard Argy loses possession once again, and now it's Niall Donaghy. Niall Donaghy into the centre forward, Paul Stewart. Paul Stewart looking good going forward into the semicircle. And a quick bit of thinking as he slipped there, and the ball broke away, but he got it out to Brian McCabe on the far side. Brian back into Niall again. Outside the 21-yard line. Then Stephen Fitzpatrick, the centre half back. One that was direct up in the air. Back down it comes. Then gathered and picked up here by the left half forward, Paul McCabe. Paul had 7 points in the semi-final. Forced to punch the ball back out to the other Paul, and that's Paul Finlay. And Paul from 35 yards out, a high one that's going way out to the left of the upright, and it's wide. So it's still one goal and 2 points each. 5 points apiece, the sides level, 27 minutes gone of this first half. Meanwhile, David Waugh, the St. Aidan's goalkeeper down here to our right, he will kick out for St. Aidan's. They play from right to left in this first half. And the kick out, dropping short also around the 45-metre line. It's Ballybay that's coming forward again. And Paul Stewart with one that's back in towards the goalmouth, hopping in the direction of the goalkeeper. He got it all right. And a very dodgy pass right across the goalmouth. But lucky for St. Aidan's, and indeed John McCary was there to meet it. John got it out to the 50-yard line, where the referee has again blown his whistle for some holding. And a free now to Cootehill. This one on the 45-metre line down here to our right. And that one taken by Keith Fannin. Keith Fannin from Drumgoon up to the middle. Ball breaking to the ground, loose once again. 2, 3, 4, 5 players in after it. The referee, well, I think he's going, yes, in fact, he's going to throw up the ball just inside the 70-yard line to our right. And that's precisely what he's going to do. These sides are deadlocked with 5 points each, or a goal and two. And higher than anybody else, Stephen Fitzpatrick from Latton. Right through the centre. McCary pulling a little bit dangerously there as the full forward knocked it out to an open space. But the ball dribbling now towards the end line. In fact, it's gone out over the end line, and it has gone wide. So it's still one goal and 2 points apiece. We have 28 minutes gone in this first half. Meanwhile, the referee, well, in actual fact, it now appears as though, obviously, that somebody had touched this ball as it was dribbling out over the end line. The umpire did signal the ball went wide, but in fact, it's a 45 now. A 45 for Ballybay, and Paul Finlay is going to take it. Colwyn's obviously thinking there and trying to plot something there as he had his centre forward out on his left. He was going to try the short ball, but now he's decided that he's going to send this one right into the house, so to speak. And as he does, it drops. And in there is John McCary as the ball broke again to the ground. John McCary was on it like a flash, and John has also been descended on like a flash, and the referee awarding a free outfield. And that free out to the 50-yard line, rather, as Ballybay come forward again. And now it's Paul Finley. Paul Finley, 45 metres out. Going right, then going left, and then across into the centre. Tapping it out to the far side of the field. Anxious to get a score or two now before the break and get back into the lead. As the centre half forward, Paul Stewart, was robbed. St. Aidan's Cootehill comes sweeping away with this one, and it's Aidan Cossum. And Aidan Cossum being fouled just outside the 70-yard line. Aidan, incidentally, one of two brothers, the other being Ronan, in the corner back position. Two brothers, and that, incidentally, are the last of seven brothers that have been great contributors to St. Aidan's school down through the years. However, as Cootehill come forward, and Shane McGarry, and Shane has sent the ball in, and he's put it over the bar. One goal and 3 points for St. Aidan's, and Ballybay Community College, and a goal and two. That means, of course, that there's just a point between them, and the game is quite young yet. We have exactly 30 minutes gone, almost halfway through the game, and Emma Gleeson to take the kick out for Ballybay down here to our left once again. And Emmett placing on the 20-metre line as he comes out to place on the 20. We're into injury time now of this first half, and that is precisely what he does. The referee, in fact, is looking at his watch, and there it goes. In fact, the half-time whistle with exactly 31 minutes gone in this first half here in Clonus. 31 minutes gone. It's one goal and 3 points for St. Aidan's Cootehill. Ballybay on a goal and two. Niall Donaghy that got the goal for Ballybay there in the closing moments of that first half, well after 21 minutes I think it was of that first half, and really brought them back into it. So there's certainly been very little between these sides here this afternoon. And again I say to you, our coverage on this Ulster Vocational Schools football final between St. Aidan's Cootehill and Ballybay Community College has been brought to you in association with Sean Shields bookmakers, Cavan, Cootehill, Ballyborough and also Virginia, where they have up-to-date prices on every event, and indeed early morning prices on every event, including of course races, which will be obviously the big thing there. Well, it may not be a day for racing out here in front, because to use the terms from that world of sport, the going is rather heavy, to say the very least. However, it's all to play for yet, with 1-3 to 1-2 in favour of St. Aidan's. And just before I hand back to you, I want to give a very special mention to a lady that will be listening to us this afternoon, and her name is Bridget Murray. Bridget Murray lives at Billis in Cavan, and this lady is an ardent supporter of football for many, many years, and in particular for Cavan Gales. And not only that, she's been attending football matches for countless numbers of years, but in more recent years, and I suppose because of time and little things like that, she certainly relies very much on the radio, but very, very active, and a lovely woman, a great friend. And again, I say a very good afternoon to Bridget Murray, Billis in Cavan, and every match she goes to, she would normally take the umbrella. Yes, yes, Fintan. Hello? Oh. Hello, Fintan. Hello? Yes, Fintan. Ready to go? Well, the second half now, only seconds underway there, and a nice move, an early attack there from Ballybay Community College, finishing with the ball winding up in the back of the net. Yes, and would you believe it that the second half is only seconds old, about 50 seconds old, and an early attack from Ballybay, and the ball winding up in the back of the Cootehill net, believe it or not. I'll just go back on that again. The second half, about 50 seconds old, and Ballybay Community College tore into it, got this game by the scruff of the neck, went forward. The ball wound up with Niall Donaghy, the man that got the goal in the first half. He transferred it outside the edge of the square, right across the goal mouth, and in after it like a flash was Jonathan Rutledge, and he got his fist to it and knocked it down and in for a very, very valuable goal. And the scoreboard now reads Ballybay with 2 goals and 2 points, and St. Aidan's Cootehill, they have 1 goal and 3 points. But certainly what a dream start there for Ballybay in the early seconds, and I do mean literally seconds of this second half. Now then, up at the other end, there's a free for St. Aidan's Cootehill from about 35 yards out, and in fact that's gone out over the end line to the right and it's gone wide. A wide in the first minute of this second half for St. Aidan's, and a goal for Ballybay that was finished clinically by Jonathan Rutledge. Jonathan, who wasn't even listed on the programme, incidentally, but as I said earlier, he got the baptism of fire, and in there wearing number 15 at top of the left, and indeed had quite a good first half, but he did his work and did it very well after the transfer from Niall Donaghy on the far right. 2 goals and 2 points for Ballybay, and 1 goal and 3. Cootehill are making a change, and we'll sort that out in a moment. A very strong, bright sun now, and the Cootehill full-back, rather, John McDonald, seemed to be replaced. Meanwhile, from the short kick out to the 50-yard line, it's Ballybay that are picking up the pieces, and Stephen Fitzpatrick right up through the centre now, setting up another attack as the full forward comes out to it. Brendan Lennon and the captain. Brendan a little bit further in. In there again was Niall Donaghy, but he didn't get to that one, as the ball was picked up by Roland Crossan and then eventually cleared out to the 50-yard line on the far side of the field, where there was a foul on the left half-back here for Cootehill, Jerry Argy on the far side, and a short and a quick free very close to the sideline. In fact, it's gone out over the sideline here now, and it's a line ball for Ballybay. A right-footed one and a lobbing one back in towards the 21-yard line, or the general direction in there. Back here is Jared Argy, and Jared is fouled coming up with the ball. He takes the free himself right up to the middle now, where St. Aidan's will be no doubt anxious to come forward and try and pick up there where they left off. Meanwhile, it's the top of the right man, Brian Bates. Brian had a goal and a point in the semi-final. Meanwhile, his pass going astray and coming away with the ball, Enda Keenan. Enda Keenan up to right half forward, Brian McCabe. Brian McCabe to the centre forward, Paul Stewart. Paul Stewart, 35 yards out, in a dangerous kind of lobbing ball that dropped a little bit short, but the goalkeeper gauged it very well. He came out and cleared it way out to the far side of the field. And out there is Brian Bates. Brian Bates into the centre for St. Aidan's. The centre back and captain is Donan Kassan. Kassan right up through the middle, but down at the other end for Ballybay, Edmund Lennon, the halfback, and then the midfielder, Noel Coyle. Noel Coyle right footed right through the centre again, but it intercepted back here down in defence for Cootehill by Damien Hannigan. Damien Hannigan is the man that's in the game, with John McDonald being called ashore. Meanwhile, St. Aidan's are on the move now again, about 45 metres out, a little more than, but they again lose possession, and this time it's to Niall Traynor, the cornerback for Ballybay, who clears it out to the side of the field. Close to the sideline, but not over. Jonathan Rutledge back into the centre again, but there's a push in the back here on Brian McCabe, and the free to Ballybay, halfway between the 70-yard line and the halfway line, just down here in front of us, and Brian McCabe will take the kick himself. Right footed up along the left-hand side here. A little bit of jersey holding, but the referee allows the play go on, as Brendan Lennon is in possession now, and this now being very definitely a foul. A little bit of jersey holding, all right, that the referee gave whatever advantage was in it, but it was to be followed up by a foul and indeed a free. 13 metres out to Ballybay, a free, and 13 metres, about 20 in from the near sideline, down here to our left. That scoreboard reads 2 goals and 2 points for Ballybay Community College, and St. Aidan's Cootehill with a goal and three. And a short free this time that eventually was out to the right of the upright. It was Paul Stewart that took the pass. It went out to the right of the post and it went wide. So it's still 8 points to 6. 8 points to 6 in favour of Ballybay. And the second half is now, what, 4.5 minutes old? 4.5 minutes old, as that strong, bright sun continues. The rain has stopped, but conditions are greasy after so much inclement weather, and in particular that downpour that we had just before the game. Meanwhile, David Ward. David's kick out to the 45-metre line, but it's Niall Donaghy, higher than anybody else for Ballybay, into Brendan Lennon, the full forward and captain again, and Brendan dropping one right into the chest of the goalkeeper, David Ward, and David clears it out to the 14-yard line, a little short of where it has been added to up along this near side of the field, and coming down to it now, Shane McGarry. But Shane McGarry doesn't hold possession. Stephen Fitzpatrick does, and Stephen gets it across into Paul Stewart. Paul Stewart, 35 yards out, going left then right. He's surrounded by three Cootehill players, and eventually the ball will not be ready. The referee has blown his whistle, and he's now awarding a free out. Awarding a free out, and quite truthfully, Paul Stewart was a little bit unlucky there with three, in fact, four St. Aidan's players around him. We've got the feeling the free might have been going the other way, but the referee is much closer than we are. However, down into the halfway line, and it's held in the centre here by Aidan Crossan. Aidan was fouled, and Aidan got up and took the free and sent it into the semicircle. Held back here by the right half-back for Ballybay, Enda Keenan, as he delivers out to an open space on the far side. Niall Donaghy out after it. He's got that ball, and he taps it across into the centre to Noel Coyle. Noel Coyle, right-footed one, way up along the far wing. The full forward coming down to it. For Ballybay, that is, and not too far away is John McCary. John McCary and the full-back are still tussling. And tussling indeed they are, but it's eventually a completely different player. It was the full-back for St. Aidan's that got it, and in his shortest clearance went completely astray. And now Ballybay are attacking with a left-footed one right across the goal mouth. It's not going to go wide or anything like it. And for seconds there was nobody near that ball, but eventually it was gathered up and cleared out, and there to meet it, Michael Hannon. Michael Hannon up to the middle, but his kick is intercepted here by Stephen Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick for Ballybay across into the centre, inside the 70-yard line. The referee has blown his whistle for a foul here on Paul Finlay, Ballybay. He gets up and takes the free very quickly himself. And there's yet another free, this one for a foul on Brian McCabe. And Brian sends it out to the far side of the field. But Ronan Crossan for St. Aidan's collects the ball and clears it up to the 70-yard line. But just as he does, out around the central field area, where Ballybay seemed to be holding the balance of power, it was Noel Coyle first, then Paul Finlay. And that cheer will tell you that Paul has done the honours. He's put the ball over the bar, and now it's 2-3 to 1-3. That means just a goal between them, and we've 7 minutes and a bit gone in this second half. And our coverage again being brought to you in association with Sean Sheen's Bookmakers. Cavan, Cootehill, Bayborough and Virginia, where they've got up-to-date prices on every event. And it's this kind of game here this afternoon. Well, it would be very, very difficult to throw a few bob if you're inclined that way as to who is going to pick up this one. But somehow, in particular in this second half, Ballybay seem to be holding the balance of power more so out around the centre field area. Not only that, their finishing has improved certainly a great deal in the early stages of this second half, having less problems with that target. Though it was 1-3 to 1-2, with 1 point between them at the break, that was. Here's Ballybay and Paul Stewart now on the attack again in the semicircle. Fisting one out to the full forward, Lennon. Lennon 25 yards down, a high one and a good one. Brendan Lennon, the full forward there, from about 24 or 5 yards out, taking the pass perfect, doing the simple thing, simplicity very much the name of his game, sending the ball in and puts it over the bar. It's now 2-4 to 1-3 in favour of Ballybay. 10 points to 6, 4 points between them, 8 minutes and 25 seconds gone in this second half here in Clonus. Meanwhile, David Ward to kick out. David placing on the 20-metre line. Down here to in front of the goalmouth, that is, on our left. And just as he does now, all eyes out around the central field area. Whence this ball will arrive. And indeed, up to meet it, and arriving up there to meet it, was Niall Donaghy, rather, for Ballybay. His kick has somehow gone astray as Cootehill on the defensive once again, but the referee has blown his whistle. Some holding, some punching, call it what you will, on a day when it's quite slippery out there. The referee awarding a free inside the 50-metre line to Ballybay. It's just a couple of metres inside the 45-metre line. Down here to our left, and Paul Stewart is the centre-half forward, and he's going to take the kick. 2-4 to 1-3 in favour of Ballybay. This one's sailing out to the right, in fact. And it's still 2 goals and 4 points for Ballybay Community College, and a goal of 3 for St. Aidan's Cootehill. St. Aidan's are a side that have won provincial title to their credit at senior level back in 1978, when they won not the Tom Market Cup, but rather the Toner Cup. However, ball being placed on the square once more for this kick out down to the left. Again, I said that the supporters are perhaps expecting something more from both these sides, these near neighbours, and always a fair bit of rivalry. And while it's in and out, little stints of it here and there, the quality of football, I suppose, under the weather conditions ain't all that bad. However, this kick out from David Ward from the square down here to the goalmouth on her left, dropping short to the 45. Gerard Arga goes up for it, brings it down for St. Aidan's inside the 50 yard line, is fouled and was a frame and a swipe after the referee had his back to it, but the St. Aidan's defender did have a crack there at his opponent that went down. Now whether he fell or whether he was pushed, that might be another story. The referee didn't see it anyway. Meanwhile, the play continues, and it's St. Aidan's now moving inside the 70-yard line. This time it's top of the right man from Drumgoon, and that's Brian Bates. Still Brian on the 45. Low ball along the ground to Aidan Clawson. Aidan Clawson has been obstructed. That would be perhaps the best term to use for it. The referee awarding a free in about 35 metres out to St. Aidan's Cootehill. About 35 to 37 metres out, a little to the left of the goal mouth, down here on our right. And it will be Aidan Crossan, the centre half forward, to send a high one. And he's put it straight in and over the bar. Narrows the gap now, back to 3 points once again. It's now 2-4 to 1-4 in favour of Ballybay in a game and a second half that has gone 12 minutes old. In fact, we're coming up at 13 minutes now of this second half. And Emmett Gleeson will kick out for Ballybay from the 20-metre line down here to our right. So Emmett placing on that 20-metre line. Certainly a lot of football taking its toll, obviously, on the playing conditions, with the weather being so inclement with all the rain and downpours that we've been having in recent times. Meanwhile, Ballybay attacking up at the other end, and right half forward Brian McCabe sent in a high one, but it went out over the end line and it went wide. And just to repeat that score once again, 2-4 for Ballybay, and Cootehill there on a goal and four. 3 points between them and 13 minutes gone in this second half. So the ball to be placed, when recovered, when retrieved from way out behind the goal mark down here on the left. About 1,000 people, I would think, here this afternoon, enjoying to an extent the exchanges of this Ulster Vocational School's football final for the Markey Cup. And they've eventually got the ball back in now, so it's been placed down here by the goalkeeper, and very shortly now they kick out. Very, very shortly indeed, with 12, 13 minutes almost gone into this first half, and a very short kick out. However, it finds the corner back, Niall Traynor, for St. Aidan's now right up to the centre, and here coming forward now is Michael Hannan, 35 yards out, a right footed one. It's going out to the right, it's dribbling out over the end line, and harmlessly so, and it has gone wide. So it's still 2-4 to 1-4 in favour of Ballybay, but that one goal between the sides. And of course we mention of Paddy Kerr being very much involved with the Ballybay Community College. Certainly plays no small part in their powers, none more so than he did when he was out on the field of play himself. Meanwhile, John McDermott, the man that's at the helm with the St. Aidan's Cootehill. However, Ballybay defending down here to our right once again. Out to this side of the field, Jonathan Rutledge. Then, right half forward, Brian McCabe. Then, Enda Keenan from defence, way up into attack with a long ball, inside the 50-yard line. It's gone out over the sideline, down here to our left. There's a line ball in some direction with two players quite close. In fact, it's a Ballybay ball, and it's in now where the centre half back is way upfield. And in after that, that's Stephen Fitzpatrick from Latton. And Stephen trying to get it across in front of the goal mark, but it failed to do so. In fact, it spun out over the end line, and the referee is in there, and I think he has signalled that, in fact, that the defender may have touched the ball, and that it will be a 45, and a 45 it is. To Ballybay, about 5 or 6 metres to the right of the goal mouth, down here on our left. Ballybay Community College, I think I told you that of course they were formed back in 1966, and there's something like 250 pupils there, that's with boys and girls, and by contrast St. Aidan's and Cootehill around the same time in 1966, and they've got 620 pupils, boys and girls. Meanwhile, on the scoreboard this afternoon and at the end, I suppose, is what's most important for these youngsters, as this floating 45 dropped right in, but it was held back there by the cornerback, Ronan Crossan, who eventually got it out to this side of the field, where Cootehill and Shane McCarty for a moment on the move, but then gets rid of the ball to the full forward. He's way out the field, incidentally, the full forward, and his full back in front of the goal mark coming out with the ball. And then eventually it's Paul Finlay for Ballybay, deep inside the 50-yard line at the other end. But the ball gathered and collected back here by Dallin Cassan. Cassan for Cootehill, way out to the far side of the field, where there's been a foul on a Ballybay defender in Edmund Lennon. He's on the ground, and the referee will be awarding the free to Ballybay, and this one will be just inside their own 65-metre line. And Edmund still on the ground there towards the far side. The referee just going across to check to see that he will be all right and that he'll be able to continue. Well, that's certainly one thing that he and indeed his mentors would be hoping. But Edmund is still on the ground, now picks himself back up, and a little bit shaken, but I think he's good enough to continue. Ballybay, incidentally, appear to be introducing a substitution. And it looks as though Edmund Sullivan is coming in now. And we'll sort out very shortly who will be coming off. Meanwhile, the other man, Edmund Lennon, he's back up and he's all right. And St. David's Cootehill are also introducing a sub. A lot of stop start in this, but St. David's have a substitution going in, though the players continue, or at least he's running right across the field. Meanwhile, the resulting free inside the 50-yard line, and going back here to gather it up is Dallin Cassan. Dallin Cassan for St. Aidan's Cootehill. Then the right half forward Shane McGarry in there to Michael Hannon, who failed to keep the ball from going out over the sideline. And there's a line ball down here in front to Ballybay. Line ball about 65, in fact it's just inside the 65, about a foot inside the 65-metre line. Conor McDermott appears to be coming in now here for St. Aidan's Cootehill. Conor McDermott coming in, and it looks as though Paul McCabe is gone off. Yeah, Paul McCabe off. Meanwhile, that's for Paul off for Ballybay with Edmund Sullivan in. Meanwhile, we'll follow the play down at the other end of the field, and Mark Kelly is the player that has been replaced there by Conor McDermott. And Ballybay are on the attack, centre half forward, about 25 yards out, high, right across the 14-yard line, or thereabouts, and in to pounce on that ball is Brian McCabe. The ball knocked away for a minute here from Brian, and it's out towards the 45-metre line once again, but Ballybay pressing forward, and it's their left half-back that's coming forward, Edmund Lennon, but his effort has gone out over the end line, and in fact it has gone wide. So the scoreboard reads 2 goals and 4 points for Ballybay, and 1 goal and 4 points for St. Aidan's Cootehill. And we have 17 minutes gone now in this second half here at St. Tiernach's Park in Tonus of this Ulster Vocational Schools football final between these near neighbours. So, it will be of interest as we wait to see who will be picking up the Markey Cup. Again, the short kick out from the goalkeeper down here, David Ward. But that's the nature of the afternoon from both goalkeepers and indeed the kick outs in general. However, Cootehill trying to set up an attack, but it's not easy down here. And again, there's good defensive work back here by Patrick Fitzpatrick for Ballybay as he gets it right up through the centre now to Brian McCabe outside the 50-yard line. Brian with the high one, a dropping ball out towards the far right. Knocked down there by Enda Keenan. And Enda apparently got a bit of a dump to the referee, awarding the free outfield. In fact, way outfield, and it's on the far side now. It's Niall Traynor. Niall Traynor for Ballybay that gathers up the pieces. Then Edmund Sullivan. Right-footed one from Edmund, right into the edge of the square to the full forward. He couldn't miss, but he put it over the bar. Brendan Lennon of Wall, somehow as the ball came in, he was inside the defence, he grabbed the ball, turned around, and for the life of me, why he didn't go for the goal, but he took what the Lord gave him. He was satisfied. He took the point and sent the ball over the bar. 2-5 to 1-4 in favour of Ballybay, and from the kick-out, it's Cootehill that are trying to get it up. They're out there to Stephen Fitzpatrick for Ballybay. Then Brian McCabe everywhere. Then the other man is Niall Donaghy. And eventually Ballybay pressing forward in the name of Paul Finlay. Paul Finlay transfers to Noel Coyle. Noel Coyle chasing now towards the 21-yard line, then decides to pause for a moment, and in doing so, he's put the ball out over the end line and wide. It's still 2-5 to 1-4 in favour of Ballybay with 19 minutes and a half gone in this second half here in Clonus. David Ward's quick kick out. The Till know now that they have a big task in front of them in the last 13 minutes or so of this school's final between these great rivals. Meanwhile, outside the 45-metre line, there's a Cootehill player on the ground. The referee is also speaking to what would have been, at least for seconds, his opponent. And still on the ground, the name of one of the Ballybay players gone in there into the referee's book. But I don't think it's anything too serious, or at least let's hope it's not. I think he's going to get up very, very shortly. And in fact, he is back up now on his feet. All the people that are around there, but in fact it was Gerard Argue that was down, and Gerard is back up now, and well, I'm sure that he's raring to go. 2-5 to 1-4, that's 11-7, and now 20 minutes of this second half. Meanwhile, from the resulting free, St. Aidan's on the attack on the halfway line, trying to set up an attack, and it's certainly not been easy for them. More eventually with Michael Hannon now. Michael Hannon taps it across to the far side. McEnroe is coming forward. Then the substitute, Conor McDermott. Local man there in Cootehill. Out to the top of the right man in Brian Bates. Brian Bates trying to link up with McDermott inside. Succeeds in doing so. He's tripped inside the 50-yard line. And the free to St. Aidan's. In fact, Conor McDermott takes it himself. A very, very short one to the right. Well, way upfield is Keith Fannin. Keith Fannin with the short ball also towards the 14-yard line. I think the players are becoming a little bit exhausted somehow on both sides, with the underfoot conditions slowing them up, so to speak. The ball finished out over the end line anyway, and it went wide, so it's still 2-5 to 1-4. All being placed by Emmett Gleeson for the kick out now. 2-5 to 1-4, that's 11-7, 4 points between them. And that's with 23 minutes gone, or 7 minutes left in the game. 7 minutes to go, 4 points between them. Ballybay looking the better at this stage. However, this is too, a very poor kick out. And it's full forward here now for Cootehill. Aidan Lennon outside the 21-yard line. Trying to chip it inside, for there'll be something on here. It's midfielder Hannon, transfers to Coyle. Coyle outside the 14-yard line has put the ball over the bar. How they might have liked a goal, but I think they took what was nice to see for them coming to them, and that was the opportunity of taking a point, and they sent the ball over the bar. It's now 2-5 to 1-5 in favour of Ballybay. 2-5 to 1-5 with 24 minutes gone into this second half. That means about just over 6 minutes left in the game, and the ball being placed by Emma Gleeson for the kick out down here to our right once again. As he comes forward, the sun has gone back in, incidentally, but the rain has been keeping away. But it's certainly left its mark down towards the 65-metre line. Continuing improving a little now in the last few minutes. That time, Paul McEnroe landing one in to Aidan, crossing the central forward, and there could be something on. It's a goal! It's a goal! And I do believe it was the sub. With the substitution that got it, the ball wound up on the left corner of the net anyway, and I do believe that it was Conor McDermott, the man that came in, and he too took a pass, went forward, went in, and sent it into the left-hand corner. And now, would you believe it, the scoreboard reads something like this. What we see, 2-5 for Ballybay, and St. Aidan's Cootehill, 2-5. Stalemate. And Cootehill on the attack from the kick-out. Aidan crossing, punching one forward. Out to the right to Shane McGarry. Shane's kick is high, but it's going to go wide. It's going to go wide, and it's still 11 points each. 11 points each. And what have we now? 5 minutes left in the game. So that goal coming after about 25 minutes or so in this second half here. And coming also at a stage prior to that, when it looked as though the Community College Ballybay seemed to be holding a tighter grip on the game. But somehow McDermott got inside there and did well and put it away and put the sides level and from the kick out to the 50-yard line, they're on the attack again. Cootehill, that is. And it's the full forward, Brendan Lennon, that's way out the field. Taps it across outside the semicircle to Aidan Crossan. Crossan tapping it back again to the full forward, Lennon. Aidan Lennon out to the far side to the half-back. The ball is wide anyway. The half-back was Gerard Argy, and the ball went out over the end line and it went wide. Wide it went, 2-5 apiece. Less than 5 minutes to go in this vocational school's football final that's been brought to you this afternoon in association with Sean Shields Bookmakers, where they've got up-to-date prices on every event. And I'm sure that would include the school's football final here. Meanwhile, from the kick-out, ball held by Paul Finlay. Paul Finlay right up to the centre for Ballybay. Oh, they're going to get a goal at the other end. It's their full forward, Brendan Lennon, that's in after it. Brendan Lennon still in possession, moving towards the edge of the square, but his kick is smothered somehow by Ronan Cossan, and indeed in the name of John McCarty, also back there in the defence. And for them, they were lucky, Cootehill, and they got it away and got it out, and out they get it to Shane McGarry. Shane McGarry delivers along this near side of the field, and it slides out over the sideline, and sliding after it also was Brian Bates. Line ball to Ballybay outside the 50-yard line, and it's in the Keenan with a short kick into the centre. That finds Paul Finlay. Paul Finlay right up to the centre, outside the semi-circle, brought down by a defender. Then the midfielder, Michael Hannon. Michael Hannon taps it out towards the far side, where it is now delivered up to the centre to Conor McDermott. Conor McDermott gets delivered to the full forward. Here, Aidan Lennon. Aidan Lennon racing towards the semi-circle, 25 yards out, a right-footed one, and it's knocked out on the edge of the square by the corner forward, Brian Bates, but it did go out over the end line and it went wide. Brian was just outside the square and he went for the ball, seemed to have it for a split second, let it slip, it slipped out over the end line and it went wide, so it's still 2-5 to 2-5, nobody in front. And we have fought 27 minutes gone, so about 3 minutes or thereabouts left in the game. And from the kick out, it's Ballybay full-back outfield, here's Sean McCabe. And Sean McCabe is fouled inside the 50-yard line, and the three for Ballybay, to be taken by Paul Finlay. Paul Finlay right up to the centre. Again, the ball, no clean catching. It's not that kind of an afternoon for that. However, in possession now for St. Aidan's, Aidan Lennon. Aidan Lennon out to the right here to Brian Bates. Brian Bates, 35 yards out, being tackled, being challenged, not being fouled. Eventually Aidan Lennon again landing one in, but it's held back here by Niall Traynor. And Niall Traynor for Ballybay chipped it out to the 50-yard line. Nice slick catch down here in front. Nice catching by Niall Donaghy. Niall Donaghy, the corner forward, who's back helping the defence now and moving forward. The next score could be very, very vital indeed. Paul Stewart a little bit further in. In there too is Brian McCabe. Brian McCabe taps it back to Paul Stewart. Paul Stewart out to Declan, to Noel Coyle rather, and Noel Coyle put it out over the end line and wide. How valuable that one would have been had it gone over the bar with a little over 2 minutes left in the game, but it went to the right, it went wide, and the score 2-5 for Ballybay. Cootehill, they have also 2-5. The prospects of a draw. Maybe you should talk to Sean Shields at this stage. Meanwhile, the ball being placed on the edge of the square for the kick out. 2 minutes left in the game. Kick out. Dropping short again off the 50-yard line, but brought down by Keith Fanning for St. Aidan's. Keith grabs and turns around and sends it up to the 70-yard line, but here to meet it is the ever-alert Paul Finlay. And Paul Finlay being fouled, and this is a free to Ballybay outside the 45-metre line to our left. Paul Finlay, the pair that was fouled, and very definitely fouled at that too. So Paul giving instructions inside for his pairs to spread out. Nobody that anxious to take this free, but I do believe that Paul is going to take it himself now. And he was initially going to try a short one, and indeed he continues to do so, but because he's simply going to work it out all that well for him, as Aidan Lennon, the full forward for Cootehill, is back in his defence, and he gets it up along the far side of the field to Conor McDermott. McDermott is pushed apparently, and the referee awarding a free now to St. Aidan, 70 yards out from the Ballybay goalmouth, out to the far side. So Gerard Argy sends it across into the centre. So Dayton is trying to get inside, but there's a foul or a pull here on Aidan Crossan, and the free to St. Aidan's is about, or will be about 60 metres out from the goal mouth down here to our right. Aidan Crossan is down, and Aidan Crossan is not out by any means, or at least one would hope not. 2-5 to 2-5. We're into the last minute now, coming very, very close, in fact, to the final whistle. A game that somehow never really got off the ground, and all the expectations as to this being a cracker and that being a cracker and the other being a cracker, well, they don't always work out that way. But again, one has to take into consideration, of course, how the weather took its toll, particularly before the game. Well, no need to tell you who those supporters are shouting for. And a point now, as we move into injury time, would be certainly very, very beneficial to either side. This free for Cootehill is outside that 50-yard line. It's sent way out to the right here now, where the midfielder Paul McEnroe has got it. And Paul McEnroe is fouled on the 21-yard line, and this is a free in. This is a free in. It's a free that I wouldn't be one bit in the least interested in taking. It's on the 20-meter line. It's about 12 meters to the right of the goal mouth, down here on our right. It's not an awkward angle, but perhaps it's a difficult situation. 20 meters out, 12 to the right of the goal mouth on the right, and it's Brian Bates, who scored a goal and a point in the semi. He's going to take this one. If he sends it over the bar, it could be a special. Well, the cheer will tell you the story of nothing more, but he did put the ball over the bar, and St. Aidan's Cootehill are now leading by the narrowest of margins. But it's not over yet, as the ball is down into the centre of the field. And tussling on the far side, the two midfielders, however, it's a Cootehill defender that comes forward, and Gerard Argy with the long ball up to the 50-yard line. And down at the other end, Paul Finlay, for Ballybay. And now they're coming forward. Now it's Brian McCabe. Brian McCabe has got a man on his left, but he's going through outside the edge of the square, dropping the ball to the ground. Well, to get it back up again. Eventually, Stevens with Patrick, and Stevens 35 yards out, a right-footed dropping dangerous ball in towards the goal mouth, but it's held back here by a defender, and that defender was Ronan Crossan, and Ronan gets it down to the 50-yard line. But it's Ballybay's Niall Donahue that gets it inside to Brendan Lennon. Brendan Lennon, 44 or 5 yards out, a dangerous ball right in towards the goal mouth. Somebody in there, it was the corner forward, Jonathan Rutledge, tried to double on it, early in style, but he did not get into the net, but he failed to do so. The referee has blown the final whistle. The game is over. The final score, 2 goals and 6 points for St. Aidan's Cootehill, and Ballybay with 2 goals and 5 points. Wow, what a way to win a game, but what a way to lose it, because there was certainly very little between the sides right throughout. And in that second half, and for the first 15 minutes in particular, one got the impression that Ballybay were the side that might go the distance. But somehow St. Aidan's found new life, and in particular when they introduced new legs, so to speak, bringing in Conor McDermott, and Conor did very well. He got a pass with about 12 minutes to go of the game. He took the opportunity from about 35 yards out. He went in and then sent it into the left corner of the net, and that put the sides level at that stage, and Cootehill were back in business. And back in business they were, back in business they are. And now, very shortly, the presentation of the Tom Markey Cup that will be taking place down in front of us. But a one-point win in the end for St. Aidan's, a game that was certainly hard fought because of the conditions and because of the weather and what have you. It was quite slippery, no doubt, but they served up, I suppose one would say, the best of football. Not a great game by any means, but they served up both sides the best of football of those two teams that haven't been able to go and the goal for the 3-5, and who is ready to become team chairman.
Thank you. first part notice. And before the presentation is made, there are a few people which we, the Business Schools Committee in Ulster, would like to thank. I'd especially like to thank all of you for being here and for witnessing such a marvellous game. I would like to thank the Ulster Council and particularly the Honour Voting Committee here in Tiernach for making their facilities available to us. It's every youngster's dream to play here in Tiernach, and it's a fitting stage for one of our finals.
Thank you.